Add your employees into Xero Payroll to begin paying them correctly. Let's see how. You need certain organization and employee information to begin. If you're coming from another payroll system, you'll find the information there. First, get their personal and tax details. That's their name, birth date, postal address, email address, and their bank account details, IRD number, tax code, and KiwiSaver details. Next, find their employment start date, how frequently you'll pay them, and their wage or salary details. Then, get their annual leave, holiday pay, and sick leave balances. If the employee already exists in your other system, get their past earnings for the last 12 months. Make sure you know the number of days you paid them and their gross earnings. If you don't have all the information you need when adding employees, just come back later. Now enter your employee's personal details and a unique email address where you'll send their payslips. If you have over 20 employees, import all their personal details at the same time. See Xero Central for more information. Next, add their start date, pay calendar, and wage or salary details. Pay calendars control how often you pay your employees. Salary and wage details control how much you pay them. If you've employed the person before using Xero, transfer their pay history for the last 12 months to their past earnings. This helps Xero calculate their annual leave entitlements. You only need to do this once, before the employee's first pay run. It's important you understand and comply with the Holidays Act 2003. You need to correctly calculate leave entitlements and annual holiday payments. Talk to your accountant or bookkeeper for more help. Xero can help estimate the past earnings by filling in the days paid and gross earnings based on their employment information. Then, compare the amounts with their past earnings from your old system and make any corrections before saving. Days paid should include any paid leave for the pay period. Unpaid weeks record the unpaid leave taken by your employee during the pay period if it's more than one consecutive week. This is because unpaid leave for less than 1 week is still considered continuous employment, and you don't need to record it as unpaid. You must enter whole numbers for days paid and unpaid weeks. For unpaid weeks, round down, but for days paid, round up. To help you enter past earnings correctly, export the gross earnings from your previous system. Make sure the gross earnings amount excludes discretionary payments, salary sacrifice amounts, and reimbursements. Let's go through a few examples. Example 1. Your employee normally works 5 days a week, and you pay them weekly. They took 1 day paid leave and worked the remaining days. You paid them for 5 days, including the 1 day of paid leave they took. In Xero, you entered 5 days paid and 0 unpaid weeks. Example 2. Your employee normally works 5 days a week, and you pay them fortnightly. They took 3 weeks unpaid leave. Since you don't count the first week, enter 0 days paid and 1 unpaid week for their first pay period. Then enter 5 days paid and 1 unpaid week for the second pay period. Example 3. Your employee normally works 5 days a week, and you pay them monthly. They took 4 weeks, the entire period, as unpaid leave. Since you don't count the first week, enter 0 days paid and 3 unpaid weeks. Now, enter your employee's tax and KiwiSaver details. Then enter the leave they're entitled to. Xero calculates their annual leave and sick leave based on the hours and days you enter, so you might not have to change them. If you need to enter any opening leave balances for employees, Xero shows you the fields to enter this information. For more complex leave, see Xero Central and talk with your accountant or bookkeeper for guidance and to comply with government legislation. Upon saving these details, your employee can now be included in a pay run. For casual employees or employees with 0 days per week and 0 hours per day, you can choose whether to pay them holiday pay in each pay. Now let's set up a pay template to tell Xero what recurring amounts to pay, deduct, or reimburse for the employee. Xero automatically includes these pay items in each pay run, saving you time. Finally, enter the bank account where you'll pay your employee. After adding staff into Xero Payroll, invite them into the Xero Me app to manage their payslips, timesheets, and leave on their mobile. It'll save you time, and it's secure. Employees only see their information, so your sensitive business data stays private. That's it. Please watch our other payroll video for more detail on employee access and user roles.